you're lucky. You really got them.
I know. Somewhere.
Thank you. Why, any kid would want to be an orphan.
I'll never know.
It's the hard knock line for us. It's the hard knock line for us.
Static treated, we get tricked. Static cases, we get tricked. It's my not a knock line.
Got the folks to spin. So it's the hard knock line.
We hold cotton blankets. Turn the whole empty belly.
Sheets once a month, whether you need them or not. Hey, Aggie. That was a pretty scary stuff for 14th Street.
Bundles, get out of here with that laundry.
So long, gorgeous, and a Merry Christmas.
You call this place clean, Annie? This place looks like a pigsty. Annie? Annie?
Annie ain't here.
What do you mean, Annie ain't here?
She went with Mr. Bondo.
In the laundry van. Bondo, please, please.
Could you donate an apple to the orphans' picnic?
Sure, why not? No one's buying them anyway.
Gee, thanks.
Say, kid, when's that orphans' picnic anyway?
As soon as I take a bite.
Give me that.
Ain't they? Well, they're after me, but don't worry, I ain't gonna let them get you for me. Everything's gonna be fine for the both of us.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just take up my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, tomorrow.
Yes, officer.
That dog there, ain't he a stray?
A stray? Oh, no, officer. He's my dog.
He's your dog. What's his name?
His name is Sandy. Right, Sandy. I call him Sandy because of his nice sandy color.
If Sandy's name, his name, what's your answer to it?
Well, you see, I just got him and sometimes...
Call him.
Sandy.
Next time you take that dog out, I want to see him with the leash and a license, or else you go straight to the pounds.
I understand.
Oh, and get along with you before you catch your death in this cold.
Oh, I don't mind the weather. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just take up my chin. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I
Yes, you too.
Good afternoon. Are you Miss Hannigan?
Yeah.
I'm Lieutenant Warfer in the 17th Precinct. We found your runaway.
Oh, thank you, officer.
She was in one of them Hoovervilles down by the river with a bunch of bums.
They weren't bums.
And a mangy mo with it, too, but he got away.
Oh, poor pumpkin. Out in the freezing cold with just this thin sweater. I hope you didn't catch influenza. Thanks so much again, officer.
All in the line of duty. And you. Don't let me hear you run away again from this nicely. Good afternoon.
The next time you walk out that door, it'll be 1953. Well, are you glad to be back? Huh?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar, with the one thing I always taught you, never tell a lie.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yeah?
I'm Grace Earle, private secretary of Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks?
Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to his home for the Christmas holiday.
What sort of orphan did he have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly and intelligent.
Mississippi, M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I.
And cheerful.
You shut up. And how old?
Oh, age doesn't really matter. Say 8 or 9? 10? 11? Yes, 11 would be perfect. And, oh, I almost forgot. Mr. Warbucks prefers red-headed children.
11? A redhead? We don't have any orphans like that.
What about this child right here?
Oh, Annie? You don't want Annie.
Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks in Mr. Warbucks' house?
I would love to.
You can have any orphan here, but not Annie.
Well, then perhaps I should call the Board of Orphans and...
If it's Annie you want, it's Annie again.
It's Annie I want.
Oh, boy!
Now, if you get her coat, I'll take her along right now.
She don't have no coat.
Then we'll buy her one.
I can hardly believe it.
She can hardly believe it.
Come along, Annie. Mr. Warbucks' limousine is waiting outside.
Hey, kids, I'm getting out for Christmas. I'll write to you.
Bye, Annie.
Now, the swimming pool is in the right.
Wow.
We have an indoor and outdoor pool.
Whoa.
And in the back is a tennis court.
A tennis court?
Yes, a tennis court. We have an instructor here at 3.
Whoa.
And to the left is your bedroom.
A bedroom?
Your very own bedroom, Manny.
Wow.
Good afternoon, Miss Farrell.
Good afternoon, Drake, everyone.
Good afternoon, Miss.
Has Mr. Warbucks arrived yet?
No, Miss. We're expecting him any minute.
Good.
Wow. Do you really?
a moment, please.
Quickly, everyone.
Everyone, this is Annie. She'll be with us for Christmas. Annie, this is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
May I take your coat, miss?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear. Now, what would you like to do first?
The floors. I'll scrub them first, then I'll get to the windows.
Annie, you won't have to do any cleaning while you're here. You're our guest, and for the next 2 weeks, you're gonna have a swell time.
Sissy will pick out all your clothes.
Please, your best color, you know, good way, please.
Your bath is drawn by Mrs. Greer. A net comes in to make your bed.
No, that's okay.
I think I'm gonna like it here. When you wake, bring for Drake. Drake will bring your tray. When your new Mrs. New comes to take me away. No need to pick up any toys.
Oh, that's okay. I haven't got any yet.
Want you to call him at the White House.
Oh, I'll get back to him tomorrow. All right, everyone, good to see you again.
Sir.
Drake, is Mr. Stack.
Yes, sir.
And Grace, if you'd get your notebook, we could start. Why, who's this?
Mr. Warbucks, this is Annie, the orphan who'll be with us for Christmas.
Orphan? That's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
Well, I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphan, so I chose a girl.
Well, I suppose she'll have to do any what?
Well, I'm just Annie, Mr. Warbucks. I'm sorry I'm not a boy.
No, I couldn't be happier. Now, Grace, we'll start on the figures on the iron ore shipment from Toledo to...
What are we supposed to do with this child?
Well, it is her first night, sir.
Well, I suppose we should do something special, since it is her first night. Would you like to go to a movie?
Gosh, Mr. Warbucks, I've never been to one.
Then you'll go to the Roxy, and then you'll have a club soda at Ruffelmeyer's and a handsome cab ride around Central Park. Grace, you can take off tonight to take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Aw, gee.
Something the matter?
Well, it's just, I thought you were going to take me.
Oh, no. I'll be far too busy tonight.
Aw, gee.
Now, Annie, I've just been away for 6 whole weeks. And when a man is running a multi-billion-dollar business...
Oh, sure, Mr. Warbucks, I understand.
Drake!
Yes, sir?
Get our coats.
Oh, boy!
Grace, you'll come too, of course.
Yes, sir.
Which car will you be wanting, sir?
The Duesenberg. No, this child's been cooped up in North Beach for too long. We'll walk to the Roxy.
Walk to the Roxy, sir?
Why not? It's only 45 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Smell the New York City air. There's nothing like it. Hurry up, you slow folks, before the price of the Roxy change.
Mm-hmm.
Once again, we bring you the romance of Helen Trent, who sets out to prove that just because a woman is 35 years or more, romance in life need not be over.
God, I hope not. Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
What's the matter? Warbucks fed up with Annie already?
On the contrary, Miss Hannigan. This has to be signed and sent back to the Board of Orphans no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is so taken with Annie that he wants to adopt her.
Annie, the daughter of a millionaire?
No, Miss Hannigan, the daughter of a billionaire.
Would you excuse me for a moment, please? Wonderful news.
Merry Christmas, Miss Hannigan.
Mr. President. No, I'm not asking for your help, but I'm telling you we've got to do something. We'll talk about it on...
Friday.
Listen, Mr. President, why don't we bury the hatchet and you and Mrs. Roosevelt come here for supper Christmas Eve?
will?
That's wonderful. Goodbye, Mr. President. Grace?
Yes, sir?
Find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
The package from Tiffany's?
Arrived this morning.
Fine. I'm going to give it to her and tell her I want to adopt her.
She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Get her down here.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
Of course not. Annie, I was born into a very poor family, and both of my parents died before I was 10. So I made a promise to myself. Someday, one way or another, I was going to be rich. Very rich.
That was a good idea.
But lately, I've realized something. No matter how much money you've got, if you have no one to share it with, if you're alone, then you might as well be broke. I picked this up for you at Tiffany's the other day.
For me? Gee, thanks. Wow.
It's a silver locket, Annie. I noticed that old, broken one you always wear. And I said to myself, I'm going to get that kid a new locket. Well, Jake.
No, I don't want a new one.
Is something the matter, Annie?
Well, you see, my mom and dad left this for me when they left me at the orphanage. And a note, too, saying they loved me and they were coming back for me. I know I'm really lucky being here with you for Christmas. But the one thing I want in the world is to be like other kids, with folks of my own.
It'll be all right. I'll find them. I'll find your parents for you.
Oh, shh. Mr. Warbucks will find your mother and father. If he has to put everyone on the organization on the job. If you have to pull every political string there is to pull.
Up to and including the White House. Annie, give me your locket.
But Mr. Warbucks.
I understand, but it could be our best clue. We'll have the FBI trace it and find out who bought it.
Okay, and maybe they should have my note too.
You watch, Annie. You may be meeting your parents within a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
I better write a letter to the kids about this.
Welcome to America's favorite radio program, The Occident Hour of Smiles, starring your old softie, Bert Healy. Good evening, Oliver Warbucks. It's nice of you to drop by.
Oh, good evening, Bert Healy. It's nice to be here.
Oliver Warbucks, I believe you have something to tell the folks back at home about little Annie here.
Yes, Bert Healy. I am now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents. Furthermore, I'm offering a certified check of $50,000 to any persons who could prove that they're Annie's parents.
Wow!
So Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of this station. Thank you, Oliver Warbucks.
Thank you, Bert Healy.
Well, I see by the old clock on the wall that another of our Thursday night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say Occident. Yes, this is Mrs. Healy's boy, Bert, saying, until next week, same time, same station. Good night.
On the radio, coast to coast. She's famous.
I wish I was on the radio.
Me too.
Who'd want to be on the top of the radio anyway?
Do with $50,000.
Excuse us, ma'am. Are you the lady that runs this hair opener?
Yeah.
Ma'am, was you working here 11 years ago?
Yeah, what do you want?
Well, we had terrible troubles back then, and I live a baby girl on the front step.
Oh, little girl.
Disappears for good. We get the 50 grand, we blow this crummy town, and then Lil and I will meet you.
Where?
Oh, yeah.
But they're all liars and fakes.
Aw, gee.
Are you certain?
Yes, sir. None of them knew about the locket. I'm so sorry.
I was sure somebody was going to be my mother and father.
This has just come by special message from the FBI.
Finally! Agent Gunderson located the manufacturer of Annie's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh, boy!
Over 90,000 were made and sold.
Aw, gee.
Annie, the FBI doesn't think there's a chance in a million of tracing your parents to this locket. I'm sorry.
That's okay. You did your best. Anyway, I guess I can get along without folks.
Grace?
Yes, sir?
Do you still have those legal papers I gave you the other day?
Right here.
Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
If I can't have my real mother and father, there's no one in the world I'd rather have for a father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
This isn't going to be just an adoption. It's going to be a celebration. And you can have anyone in the world you want to come to it. Who would you like?
Well, I guess Miss Farrell and Mr. Drake and Mrs. Pugh and, well, everyone here.
Drake? Tell the staff to get spiffed up for Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir. Oh, and the kids.
Well, it'll be way past their bedtime now, but I'll tell you what, we'll have everyone here for a big Christmas party tomorrow.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid.
Together at last. Together forever. We're tying a knot that no one can sever.
Baby girl, name Elizabeth Mudge. Born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge. New York, New York, October 28th, 1922.
October 28th, that's my birthday.
Ralph, look, Annie's wearing a locket!
We left Annie at the orphanage without half a silver locket around her neck and kept the other half.
Yup, it fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph, she's Annie!
Mr. Mudge, what about the money? You haven't heard that I've offered a certified check of $50,000 to any persons who could prove that they're Annie's parents?
No, sir.
But we ain't been needing no money.
On the other hand, right? Remember that pig farm out in Iowa? With $50,000, we can afford to bring Anna up right in the country, right?
Would you mind if Annie stayed here one more night? Christmas,
Then you can come back and pick up Annie and the check.
Whatever you prefer, sir. Bye, Annie Munch. And until tomorrow, you'll be spending the rest of your lives with us.
Oops, pardon me.
Well, this is...
wonderful news.
Drink champagne. We must celebrate. Because we've heard the most wonderful news in the world. Annie has found her mother and father. I propose a toast to Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge. Annie!
I've looked, sir.
I look Annie.
Sir, I have a strange feeling that I've seen that Mr. Mudge before. He's not who he says he is.
Then I won't give up the work, sir.
But how?
I don't care. I'll go straight to the top, to the President of the United States, even if he is a Democrat.
President Roosevelt.
Merry Christmas, Annie. Annie, earlier this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me some very sad news. The truth is tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
No, dear. David and Margaret Bennett.
But...
Annie, earlier this morning, your parents died a long time ago.
You mean a more often after all.
Are you all right, Annie?
Yes, because I know they love me. And they would have come for me if they weren't...
I love you, Annie Bennett.
I love you, too. Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shelley Mudge?
Well, the birth certificate could have easily been forged, but nobody knew about the locket except us.
And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
Hey, kids!
Miss Hannigan, I'm delighted to meet you.
Sam Heron, I'd know you anyways.
Miss Hannigan, let me introduce you to everyone. This is my butler, Drake. The President of the United States. And, of course, you know my private secretary, Miss Barron.
Look, there's presents for everyone.
Just come from the FBI.
Now it all makes sense.
Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Good morning!
This is Warren!
Merry Christmas.
Well, we don't want to bother you with being Christmas and all. So we just came to pick up Annie and the check.
Ah, yes, of course, the check. Here you go, Mr. Mudge. $50,000 certified.
Certified. Pay the owner of the jig is up.
The jig is up?
Yes, the jig is up. Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, and also known as Danny the Dick.
Lewis, turn him over.
Sack the Hawkins as a public of a la 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 la.
I didn't see these people till yesterday.
Hannigan, remember the one thing you always taught me? Never tell a lie. Miss Hannigan is gone for good!
Yay!
And you'll never have to work again.
Yay!
Yes, girls, for you and perhaps for all of us, this Christmas is going to be the beginning of a wonderful new life. A new deal. Hey, I rather like that. A new deal.
So do I, Frank.